weird dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 17 in our series, NerdDice.com, where we build a Ruby on Rails application for tabletop role-playing management. And we're using Rails 7 here and Devise to work on authenticating a user. So you can sign up for an account. We did last episode, and this episode we're going to focus on doing tests for being able to log in and log out of the account, along with things that can go wrong when that happens. So in our previous episode, we wrote our browser tests for user signs in, is able to confirm account works, you can log in, you can visit an authenticated path, which is going to be the basis for the first part of this, which is logging in with a user. So that's going to be something that we'll be able to refactor out and use between both of those two methods. But things can go wrong too. So we did, user tries to sign up with an invalid email format, an email address that's already been taken, passwords too short, passwords don't match, all those different things. User tries to hit the validation URL with a bogus validation token. So all those different things that are trying to make sure work, and we want to make sure stay working if we make changes or we do Rails upgrades or Devise upgrades or Turbo upgrades or any of those three. We want to be able to run those things with a browser that incorporates the JavaScript integration and all that, and make sure that this succeeds. So that's what we've done before. And then we'll do a similar pattern here. So we've got our user here. We've already signed up, say we log in. So we'll make assertions about the login page, and then we'll try to sign in with a user and have it work as expected. Say we signed in successfully. We can visit the members area, and then we can log out, and it says signed out successfully. Those are going to be some of the things that we're going to do. We'll break them down into smaller pieces there, and then other things that can happen. So let's say I don't think I've got a user for this, and I think kind of the generic way that this works is invalid email or password. So there's only one kind of vector there, other than you need to sign in. So those are the two. You have it blank, you need to sign in or sign up before continuing, or you've got an invalid, so that's those are the kind of the different things that we're going to try to automate here. So similar to last time, we will generate. Rails generate system test device log. Oh, what happened here? Constant name. Huh. we will just, instead of generating it, create the file. Now that we know how to, all the structure that we need for it. So call in login logout test.rb. I'll just copy and paste all of this. User we don't have any notes yet, and we'll call this log in log out test. All right, and then don't have a new user here, so this is just going to be at user equals, make it the DM. And we'll just get rid of the rest of the class and start from scratch here. Need the class end though. Okay, so we will have a test. User can log in. So in this case, we're going to go to, so from our sign up test, we essentially have this here. Fill in so this is our stuff for the login page, which is going to be shared across two different classes, so we'll just put this in our look at our login page, assert text login, we'll just add information about all the different links there when we port this over. So, all right. So we've got this whole section here. Whenever you're visiting the login page, so we we've got these things here. We'll add in the other items before we refactor it out. These. Alright, make sure that our existing tests still pass. All right, so we're still passing there. So we want to take essentially all of this, and this will become a method on application system test case. Login page assertions, keep those, and then you want to be able to log in with either a user. Just call login page assertions here, and then login with user is just going to call login with credentials with user.email. So now we should be able to call login with credentials from here. still have that test method pass. Oh, did I mean login with credentials? Let's go back. Didn't save the system test case. Got that working. And then we want to welcome page logged in assertions. Yeah, I guess that still stays the same, but then we should be able to just make this test. User can log in. Is log in with user. All right, so we should be able to have that test run and hopefully pass. Expected to find I didn't visit the page. Is it, what is the helper for that? Do Rails routes. Grep. User sign in. So it's the new user session path. All right, so we log in with user. Let's take a look at our failure. So go here. You need to sign in or sign up before continuing. So log in with user. Make sure that we have that. Log in with user, we provide the user. Log in with credentials, user.email, user.password. And throw in a debugger there. Here we are. User.password is nil. Let me take a look at my fixture. Users, encrypted password. I don't think it's going to give me the. Let me see, make sure I've got. Have to use login with for this. I might not be able to do that login with user. Rid of it for now. That's the password we have the digest for there. So let's kill Chrome, get rid of the debugger statement. Which we did when we got rid of the method, so. If it runs without. All right, so we've got failing on this assertion in line 12. Login with credentials, user.email. Just sign up before continuing. What am I doing wrong here? Login with credentials. Login page assertions. Fill in email, fill in password. Check, remember me. I'm using instance variables here. Still think I want that login with user, so I'm going to maybe it just wasn't doing that in the, so let's revert to the state where that existed and then just fix that. Well, see if we can get that test passing. By the exclusion of the instance variable. And then we'll see if login with user now works. That would make life easier. All right. So the other way to go about doing that, I'm going to keep that around, and we're going to create a requiring test helper. So I'll just throw this in test helper. Be just how do I go about doing this? I think I can still make that a string hash. Just go to our fixtures here. If we ever need to add more fixtures, we'll do it with We'll just update the here. Email here. There we go. And then this will turn into fixture user passwords. User.email. Now, I think this should pass. Unless I completely create a syntax error. Okay, I need to interpolate those, I believe. Now they're string literals. Oh, we're still failing there. Syntax error. Unexpected string literal expecting. I don't have a comma. If that will work. To do that after fixtures all, or just throw in the email hard-coded key here. I know it's brittle and not ideal, but it will make it better than having to put in a password literal every time we want to log in with somebody. So let's do that. We'll have a note here. I'm not in love with this implementation, so if something strikes me at another time to make that better, I will. But the method works. So that's good. We've got our login user test passing, and then these other ones will be login with credentials with bad data. Back to this test. So this will be the error message for our second one. This one is you need to sign up or sign in before continuing. Pretty sure it's in our history there. Skip both of these at the same time. I'm going to make the visit new user session URL part of that method, because otherwise it's going to not be usable in our other systems test cases where we need to log somebody in. All right, so got our we actually don't even need this because it's implicit. Made it implicit. I think we did the assertion about the flash before we did the visit on the sign up page. So good there. Now we need to ensure that the user can log out. here, going to get rid of that. Make the assertions about the login page again, because we're still going to be on that page. So we're going to log out, we're going to log in with the user. And then I'm going to be on the welcome page our situation that we're testing here. So log in, click on the logout button, should assert text signed out successfully. Insert that text. And then I'm going to try to visit the authenticated page. An underscore, and this should assert text. This takes you to the login page. Rerun those system tests. And we are successful. We'll check Rubocop. Mutable constant. So those are both correctable. I think we're good there. Hit that single quote. We're good. All right, Rubocop and our tests are both are all passing here. We'll add everything in here. Write my message. All right, I've got my commit message here. Let me save. Make sure I don't have any changes currently open. We will git push, pause, and let that finish. All right, our build has succeeded. We will go to our issue. Another checkbox bites the dust. Go back to our project. I had never moved it to in progress. All right, we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching this stateless code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels. Follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.